to get into it, you know what I'm saying?
RAR XD, the year is 2009 and scene kid culture is sweeping America. You've got emo bands like Paramore, Panic at the Disco, My Chemical Romance, all becoming extremely popular with these scene kids.
Yeah, I never actually like went out of my way to like listen to any of those. Like, I just happened to hear it, be like, I know this song, I've heard it before.
And not only did these scene kids love music, they had a penchant for weird internet culture, anime, and wearing thick black eyeliner. And in my book, the
weird?
Most popular scene kid ever to exist.
Look, how's that weird? How's that weird, bro? Hey, wavy.
...exist in the history of the world was Boxy.
Okay, hi. So, my name is Boxy.
Do you guys remember Boxy? She became popular in 2009 for her quirky stream of conscious rant style videos where she's just all over the place. Her LOL XD random persona became a hit online, and there was a large group of people that loved her, and she also had her fair share of haters.
She has some weird
eyes,
bro.
I'm sure suggested a video of hers back in 2009, where she became popular in just a month's time, but just as fast as she came, she pretty much disappeared back into internet obscurity. And that really is the point of the video today. Let's discuss what happened to Boxy. How did she become famous, and why did she disappear? And I'm gonna go ahead and tell you, it involves a little bit of 4chan shenanigans, some doxing, and some password hacking. And with that said, I couldn't think of a more...
Look, the only reason I made that face is now, I know 4chan don't screw around, bro. Them people over there, they different, bro. They straight up be different, bro.
Appropriate sponsor for today's video, then Dashlane. Dashlane will create ironclad passwords for you.
Hey, W promotion, bro. W promotion. W promotion.
So completely secure, encrypted under a VPN. So with the password protection, autofill, and a VPN, you really can't go wrong with Dash. 30-day free trial.
Yeah, that's
Dashlane
W.
Premium.
Thank you for the promotion, bro.
And the first 200 to click will get 10%.
Wavy, it was in there. The whole thing wasn't in there,
Premium.
But it was in there.
So with that
I got
said,
you.
Onto the video. So our story starts all the way back in 2006 with 14-year-old Katie Wayne. Katie, who is the girl behind Boxy, wasn't known as the infamous Boxy character at this time.
She rich.
She had a different alias that she was known for, and this alias was Moldy Lunchbox. Moldy Lunchbox was her username on an anime forum called Gaia Online. And Gaia Online is a forum-based website which has been around since 2004, and over the years built strong gaming and anime communities. One thing you may remember about this site if you've been on the net for a while is it featured the ability to create a custom...
Did y'all ever play this? I have friends that played this. I never played it. I was more into, like, RuneScape and stuff like that. Like, I played, like, RuneScape, bro. That was my jam.
Avatar, which represented you on the forums. Role-playing within the forums as your online alter ego was one of the hallmarks of Gaia Online as a whole. The forums did have serious topical threads, but many of its users would flock to the website to completely lose themselves in roleplay with the friends they had made on the website. So it was during the Gaia Online days as Moldy Lunchbox where Katie would go on to formulate the groundwork for the character that would become known as Boxy. The key elements of Boxy go as following: scene slash emo kid makeup with the thick black eyeliner that was popular with high school kids at the time, a quirky LOL XD random personality and mannerisms with a ridiculously fast and non-coherent speech pattern, and excessive use of internet humor and anime references. As she spent time on Gaia Online formulating this character, she would eventually release her first video debuting the Boxy persona in late December of 2008. On a website called IamBored.com, Boxy would unveil her zany character to the world in a video titled 4 Addy from Boxy, 4DD1 being a leet speak rendition of the name Addy. And Addy was a Gaia Online friend of Katie at the time.
Okay, hi. Okay. My name is Boxy. Most of you know me as, most of you know me as Boxy, I suppose. If you're watching this, you probably...
Bro, I ain't gonna lie. She's probably a nice person. She seemed cool, bro. That would have weirded me the fuck out if she kept doing that. Bro, she probably cool as shit. Don't get me wrong. She's probably cool as shit.
But, a lot of people don't know me as Moldy Lunchbox. And so, yeah, that's my Gaia username on Gaia Online. And I told my Gaia Online friend buddy, one second, I'm uncomfortable. I told my Gaia Online buddy friend, Admiral Awesome, that I would.
Oh, she got something wrong with her, bro. My bad, man. I take that back, y'all. My bad. She probably got something wrong with her. I take it back. I'm sorry. It's not too late, bro. I take it back.
I would make a video just for him, so I'm doing it. Here it is. Addy, I love you.
This video was basically a 3-minute long shout out to Addy. It's just Boxy basically saying, I love you, Addy. We're homies on Gaia. And that's really all this video is. It's not the subject matter or the dialogue in this video that got everyone's attention. It's pretty much.
Bro, can I just say, bro, you got the gift of gab, bro. Like, I just want to hear you talk about random shit, bro. Just random shit, bro. You cool, bro.
Everything else about the video.
It's no like creepiness.
An ADHD-fueled rant with these crazy mannerisms. That's what got people interested in Boxy. But this interest is about to be compounded whenever 4chan got involved. Sometime in early January of 2009...
What'd I tell y'all? What did I tell y'all? 4chan is freaking different, bro. The niggas that got the balls to be on 4chan, they different. They the type of niggas that will find out everything about you, like... pull up all your shit on the internet and fucking post that shit for everybody to see. Even if it ain't on the internet, they'll hack your system and post that shit somewhere, bro. These niggas built different. A place to lose faith in humanity. Yep.
Boxy's video was embedded in a You Rage, You Lose thread. While many...
we need some... I'm not even gonna say that word.
Many of the B users found her completely unbearable, claimed she had ADHD or was on drugs or something like that. There was a sizable camp of B who fell in love with her and developed a bit of an e-crush on Boxy. You've got some Anons dropping these bombs. I'm 23 and I would marry her anytime. I need to find me a Boxy. I would divorce my 26-year-old wife if I could marry Boxy.
This is illegal, you know.
So as Boxy's video that was shared on IMBoard and 4chan started to get popular, she decided to open up her own YouTube channel in 2009.
That's not good.
She would upload her original video and also some new content as well. Her YouTube channel name is one that would become rather infamous throughout the history of the internet. That being Boxy Babe. The
22 million
Boxy
views.
Video would go on to garner 300,000 views in a week's time, which is remarkably impressive for 2009 terms. Clearly, people were interested in the Boxy phenomena and character. 4chan's B forum was getting inundated with Boxy threads. It was clear that there was a bit of divide. There was half people who basically despised Boxy and the character, but there was also a solid half that...
And just think, I'm like, you're not a little kid on 4chan, bro. You're not a little kid on 4chan. These are grown ass men, bro. These are grown ass men on 4chan, bro. Being weird with this high school kid, bro. She kid.
That really wanted, like, they thought she was waifu material. But those who despised Boxy could not take the flooding of B with all these Boxy praising threads. And they decided to do what 4chan does best. Dox someone. They decided to launch a doxing effort towards Boxy, and this doxing effort was called Operation Valkyrie. Valkyrie consisted of scouring the internet for any social media accounts linked to Boxy, Facebook, MySpace, or maybe a first-hand account of.
What I say, bro? What did I say, bro? I told y'all, bro. I told y'all, pay me. I win. Give me my money.
Someone who knew Boxy personally. However, despite their tireless searches, days passed and B hadn't turned up anything. A break would come on January 6th when an anonymous user claiming to be Boxy posted two photos of a girl that looked remarkably similar to her, and this Anon would claim to be Boxy herself. But there was no way at the time for this user to solidly prove that this was indeed Boxy. So at this point, it was looking like Operation Valkyrie was going to be a giant flop. They couldn't turn up any solid docs on Boxy. So for the time being, 4chan was SOL. But on January 9th, Boxy proved that she had been...
In case y'all don't know what SOL means, it means shit out of luck. Just in case y'all didn't know.
Watching 4chan's doxing efforts this whole time, and she was actually the one who posted those photos onto 4chan. Boxy was playing these guys like a puppet master. This video is titled For Everyone From Boxy, and it's her basically reflecting and reacting to 4chan's efforts to dox her and the overall rise of her YouTube channel. Check it out.
Okay, hi. So, my name is Boxy, and it's been a while since I made a new video, so I decided that because of recent events that I could make a new video. And so let's just start off by getting a couple things straight. I don't do drugs. Mm-mm. No, I know that you all thought that I did.
Mm-mm. By the way, W pause screen. Matter of fact, bro, because I need a thumbnail, bro. Hey, let me get a thumbnail, bro. Hold on real quick. Hey, y'all, don't be judging me, bro. I'm getting a thumbnail real quick. There we go.
Drugs, but I don't actually, and I actually don't have ADD either. I provided you with a couple different pictures, such as like the one where I'm like, and it says, I saw what you did there, and like, and then like you peoples were all like, you was trolling, and I was like, I am not trolling, I am Boxy, you see? But this one kid, he remixed a lot of my videos, and they were so cool, and his name was Gastric Penguin, and he was so funny. He like mixed it and stuff, and I was like, oh, the first time I saw it, oh my god, I had a heart attack. I was like, oh my god.
Now note that she mentioned someone remixed her video and she was happy that they did that. This person's name is Gastric Penguin, who was,
and he got all them subscribers,
music remix of Boxy. Keep that name Gastric Penguin in your,
so I may still be able to keep this account, like, I even care, as long as I don't F around. LOL, F you too, bro. What the
back pocket, because he'll be important later in the story. Much okay. To the dismay of those involved with Operation Valkyrie, it seemed as though Boxy had gotten the better of them. Her avoidance of the docks would prove to be a frustration.
Mad, bro.
And this frustration was ever so compounded by the massive amount of Boxy supporters and defenders which idolized her within 4chan's B. Supportive Boxy threads would continue to flood B, and for those involved with taking her down, this was simply way too much to take. And they decided that if they couldn't take down Boxy, they would do the next best thing. Take down 4chan. Destroy the entire website. Enter Operation Clampdown. On January 10th, the call to arms was put out for Operation Clampdown, which was basically a site-wide effort to DDoS 4chan by the Boxy haters. As midnight approached, the Boxy haters loaded up their DDoSing software and prepared to fire the DDoS cannons towards their own website. And once midnight hit, the DDoS was released to its fullest potential, and 4chan went to a 404 error page for about 3 hours. So for a brief time, the Boxy haters had indeed won.
No, in the process, they didn't.
They basically destroyed their own forum in order to shut up the Boxy supporters just for a few hours.
In order to
they
win.
They won the battle, but the war was far from over. All the meanwhile Operation Clampdown was going on, a splinter group from the original Operation Valkyrie had been working in the shadows to dox Boxy. A group of approximately 10 people corresponding in a chat room working to complete the dox on Boxy had been established. And this group named themselves Center for Boxy Control and Restriction, or the CBRC. And curiously enough, Gastric Penguin was a member of this group. If you remember from earlier, Gastric Penguin was the guy that I told you
made the remixes
to keep in your back pocket. Because when Gastric Penguin had made this remix video for Boxy, he reached out to her and they had some detailed conversations in private. And apparently, in these detailed private conversations, Boxy had released some information to Penguin, which may have led to her doxing herself, basically.
Did he hold her?
Penguin, acting as a Benedict Arnold in this situation, gave some information to the CBRC that led them to find a MySpace account. With this MySpace account, the CBRC was able to figure out her real name, that being Katie Wayne. And in addition to finding her MySpace account, the CBRC had discovered some old YouTube video from 2006 that had her in it saying her name was Katie, and the girl looked rather similar to Boxy. They didn't know the exact address of Boxy, but they'd pinpointed her down somewhere in San Diego, California. And if all of this information being leaked to the CBRC wasn't bad enough, the CBRC had done the impossible. They managed to hack Boxy's YouTube account. On January 18th, Boxy's YouTube account was hacked, and they uploaded a video to her YouTube channel with the still image saying, "Never create another video again." Unfortunately for Boxy, after the CBRC hacked her account, she wasn't able to gain access to it for a total of 2 years. It goes to show you that 4chan is relentless and they won't stop until they achieve their goals. This time, 4chan had won. They defeated the scourge of B. Boxy was no longer the queen.
And the crazy thing, she ain't even do shit to them, bro. She ain't do nothing to these dudes, these grown-ass 30-year-old men that just wanted to bully a high schooler off YouTube, bro. For what? Don't watch the video. Grow the fuck up. Down.
So Katie Wayne, after going through what must have been complete burnout from all the online harassment, would take a break from making videos on YouTube.
And were they getting paid money back then? Like, I'd be mad if I was getting paid money back then and that happened, but like, if you aren't getting paid, it's like, okay, create another page and just upload another video, bro.
She would return with her new channel called A New Hope in 2010, but this time she would be herself, Katie Wayne, completely out of character. These were essentially just vlog-style videos where she talked about her life, and the channel would become fairly popular, amassing over 300,000 subs by this time in 2019. But Boxy as a character...
She's actually cute, bro. She ain't even do all that weird shit that she was on. She's of age now, so don't even... She's over 18. She's in college right there, see?
...would pretty much be shelved. YouTube would finally restore Boxy's Boxy Babe account sometime in 2011, and she would post more in-character Boxy videos, a handful, maybe 5 or 6 if I recall off the top of my head.
I know y'all hear that in the background, that Kendrick Lamar, bro. 30,000 feet in the air, steward is complimenting me on my nappy hair. Y'all know, bro.
It just wasn't quite the same. She was obviously through with the character, and I don't think she had much passion or interest in forwarding the Boxy brand. Her last post as Boxy was posted back in 2014, and the character has basically been defunct since that time. However, she has been somewhat active on the A New Hope channel. From 2010 to 2015, she was fairly active on A New Hope and developed a pretty solid fan base over there, getting good view counts. But yeah, out of the blue, in January of 2015, she randomly disappeared from that channel. And she would return in 2017 and updated all of her fans on what had happened. And what she says basically is that she's grown out of YouTube and is pursuing her creative endeavors off the platform, stating that she's doing voiceover work and is also working on a video game called Boxy Quest. Take a look.
Oh, hello. Did you miss me?
Probably not. I don't know who would. Who would miss these fucking amateur videos? So let's have a little chat, shall we?
We shall.
So when I first started making YouTube videos, talking about Boxy for like 2 seconds. I just wanted to make some videos for my friends. All I wanted to do was, film some videos where I amplified my personality by about 20 fucking thousand that would eventually turn into a character by the third video, and that's all that I wanted. Honestly, that's kind of how I started making videos on this channel. I had left the internet and then realized that no matter how long I was gone for, it seemed like this whole Boxy thing was gonna stick around, so I figured, like, why not, you know, try to make these videos for these people, these few people that care. And so that's what I did. I have so many other things that I wanna do, you guys. And since I left Discovery and didn't come back to YouTube, I got a job as a voice actor on the Disney Channel. I have a show coming out. I have a show coming out on June 3rd of 2017 called Billy Dilly's Super Duper Subterranean Summer, and I'm one of the...
What'd she say? Billy Dilly. Oh yeah, I'm looking it up. Billy Dilly Super Duper Subterranean Summer. Bro, what? Marsha. Played by. No, wait. What? Boxy plays as Marsha. She's legit doing her freaking voice acting. Bro, what other show has she been in? Bro, she been in mad shows, bro. Wait, what? Okay. I'm not. Oh, let's check the IMDb, y'all. Bro, don't please don't show no weird stuff. I'm literally on stream, bro. I hope this thing don't pull up nothing weird. All right. Freaking Boxy's Quest together. Oh, so this is her. I think this is her game that she made. Obituary, A Grave Beginning, The Art of Storytelling, and Billy Dilly Super Duper. But she ain't done. She last one she did was in 2019. So what's she doing now? Oh, hold up. Yes, I go to Corey Kenshin's page whenever freaking I'm going to YouTube. That's the only page that, besides your rage, that matters. Where's Boxy? A New Hope.
Oh,
Hold up, y'all. She's still 4 years ago. You played in four different things. Two of them, one of them, two of them was video games, nigga. Come back to YouTube. You got like the personality, like, bro. Ruin people's day.
The main characters.
So it's clear to me at this point, Katie Wayne is completely done with Boxy, and I would imagine the vicious assault that she had from 4chan's raids and doxing attempts would make you a little cautious about picking up the character again. Seems like she's doing okay in life now, has found her own success and a way to make a living being creative. What do you guys think about Boxy? Do you remember her, and do you remember Scene Kids being a big thing? Jesus Christ. Shout out to Dashlane for sponsoring the video. Please go check them
Yes,
out in the
sir.
description box. And major, major shout out to all of my
Yeah, there
patrons.
goes
I
patrons,
appreciate you
y'all.
guys so
There goes
much. I'll see y'all on
patrons.
the
Freaking, where's Hypnotical? Bro, I'm not gonna freaking be a true fan of yours, Wavy Web Surf, until you get freaking Hypnotical to be one of your patrons, bro. All right,
next
let's see.
video.
We
Wavy
got
Web
something
Surf
else.
out. Peace.
Yes, sir. Dang, man. I appreciate y'all watching that video. It will be put on YouTube, bro. Yo, this is pretty freaking crazy. That she's actually, bro, she ain't even do nothing wrong. I don't get that, man. Hey, it is what it is. You know what I'm saying? To each his own, bro. People want to get mad about the dumbest crap, but hey, it is what it is, bro. Y'all gotta live with that. All right.